Hello, Tammy here for this week's takeaway. I think today I'm basically going to be talking to myself because it's like I'm still kind of wrestling with something in my heart and soul. And so I think it's just going to come out that way, more of questions than answers. And so maybe when we're through with this, you won't have any answers, but maybe you'll have some questions that you want to wrestle with yourself. I don't know. We'll just see how this goes. But so I'm going to start with yesterday. I came out to my little trailer where I am right now and was spending some time with God to ask him, you know, what he wanted me to talk about for this takeaway today. And so as I'm talking to him, it's raining outside and it sounds really loud on the trailer, you know, and I'm thinking about that too, thinking, well, you know, the sound of the rain on the trailer, if I'm filming and all that, and how will that be? And at the same time, I'm enjoying the sound of it, you know, it sounded lovely, until I saw a drop came from the ceiling and right in front of my eyes. And I was like, Oh no, my trailer's got a leak, you know? And that's why I got rid of my last little trailer, because no matter what we did, I could not fix that roof to quit leaking no matter what. I mean, we replaced the roof and it still leaked. And so it was so frustrating to me that we finally just got rid of it, you know? And then I got another one and we redid the roof and all that. And I haven't had any trouble with it until yesterday. And that first drop. And then, so then I'm studying and I'm looking at where it's coming in. It's right by the vent in the corner there, you know, and then another drip. And at first I'm just feeling so frustrated inside, you know, and, you know, why God? And right. And it's just it really is just a dumb thing, right? It's just a life thing. That's all it is. And as I'm asking myself or asking God that even, right? It just pops into my head, why not? You know, and I just kind of stopped and thought, yeah, that's true, right? Why not? Why would I expect that every minute of every day is just going to be smooth sailing and just go how I want it to go, right? That is just not realistic at all, right? I mean, you've lived life. You know that isn't how life goes. There's just always stuff. There's just always stuff. And so I thought, okay, that's true. You know, that's true. And I just held out my hands and I was catching the drops in my hand. And I just said, Lord, I accept from your hand whatever it is you want to give me, whatever that is, right? And I mean, this is just a simple drip. Some of you are dealing with super heavy, heavy things. And this is a nothing thing, right? But to be able to just, whatever it is, to tell God, I accept from your hand whatever it is that you want to put into my life, right? It made me think of that scripture, 1 Samuel. It's in 1 Samuel. I had to write it down because I don't have it memorized, but I thought of it. In 1 Samuel, Samuel, who was the judge of Israel at that time, was talking to Saul, who was the first king that Israel had appointed king. And Saul was in trouble because of some stuff that he did, and Samuel's having a talk with him. And what Samuel says to him, he says, rebellion is as sinful as witchcraft, and stubbornness is as bad as worshiping idols. So I had to think about that. Rebellion is as bad as witchcraft, right? So the things I don't want to accept from God, right? The stubbornness that he talks about here of wanting my own way instead of God's way, even when it's something difficult, right? If we're supposed to pass through this difficult thing, but we want to find any other way around it, right? Or we're stubborn and we're like, not your way, God, I'm going to do it my way, right? He compares it to witchcraft and worshiping idols, right? And I had to think about, so why is that? And it's the motivation behind all of that, right? The motivation behind rebellion and behind witchcraft is that I want my own way. I want to be the one in control, the one with the power, right? And I don't want to give that to God. And so when I rebel against God, it's the same as if I'm just going to be practicing witchcraft or whatever. Or if I'm so stubborn, it's the same as if I'm worshiping idols, because who's the idol at that point? It becomes myself, right? I'm the idol. I'm worshiping myself when I want my own way instead of God's way. So that's a big thing, right? Because a lot of times what's put in front of us that God is offering us, we don't want. I don't want my trailer to leak, but it's not that big of a deal. But sometimes we're dealing with really super heavy, heavy things. And so how do we get to that place where we can release that to God? And I think that's a question for all of us. And it comes down to trust, right? To what is it that God really has in store for us? I don't like pain of any kind, right? And so I will do anything to avoid pain. I really like comfort. That's my favorite, right? So I will do things in my life to try to keep myself comfortable. But when God brings us to a place of discomfort and even pain, how do we give to Him? How do we give to Him ourselves and be accepting of that, you know? I mean, the drop was just a simple thing that my trailer's leaking. And I'm like, okay, my trailer leaks. What is so bad about that? It's not like I'm even taking it anywhere. It just lives here in my yard, you know? So I went out in the rain right then. It was pouring. I mean, just like dumping rain. I get a ladder and I get up there and I see where the water's kind of puddling right by the vent. And I don't know how to lift that part of the, you know, the roof up or anything. So I get a broom and I sweep off the extra and I just go get a tarp. And I cover it, right? And I get some bungee cords and I wrap it like a present on the outside. It's lovely. I'll just say that. And, you know, but I bungee it down all tight. And so it's not leaking in here now and I get to be in here. And really, it's just not a big deal, right? But there's so many things I know that are way, way bigger deals than my trailer leaking. And how do we, because I'm in a place now where I'm not dealing with something terrible right now, but all of life, we know that there's going to be stuff. There's bigger stuff than a trailer leaking that, you know, I've got bigger stuff in my past and I'm sure there's bigger stuff in my future. So how do I get to that place where I can just tell the Lord, I accept from your hands, whatever it is that you have for me, I trust you and I don't have to try to control it. I was reading in my devotional the other day, and one of the things that it was an Oswald Chambers, and he was saying that God takes us through storms a lot of times to not to teach us things, but to help us unlearn things. So I was thinking about what are some things that I need to unlearn, you know? I need to unlearn that God is not far away. He's right here, right? He's right there with you. He's right here with me. He's not far away. I have to unlearn that he's not preoccupied and so busy that he's not paying attention to me, that he absolutely is paying attention to me. Nothing got by him. I think that he made the drop right then, because I'm asking him, what should I talk about today? And he's like, drip, how about this? You know, let's take you to some place that I'm going to, you know, because you've got some work to do in your soul. And so, even that is from him, because he's paying attention to us all the time. Okay. I think another thing that I need to unlearn is that I don't control God. That's not my area, right? He is not controllable by us. We do not control him and we cannot manipulate him, right? Sometimes do you ever catch yourself like, oh, how would I pray about that so that God really listens to me or anything like that, right? He's already there in your head in that conversation, hearing your pre-conversation with him, right? So we can't manipulate him or trick him. And compared to us, he is completely wild, right? You cannot control him. I cannot control him. He's going to do what he's going to do. And so what I need to do is just ask him what he has for me and walk in obedience in that. Okay, so I guess I just mostly have just questions today, right? Like, how do I walk in that? And so I'm just going to spend some time in prayer with him, asking him about that. And, you know, today, how do I show him today that I just want to walk in obedience, that I'm trusting him. I give him it all, give him the trailer. It's all his anyways, right? And I hope that you guys have a great week. I look forward to talking to you next week.